most of us who have the job of journalism or the job of reporting or the job of being a columnist of some sorts, when we can do that privately in our own blogs and our own audiocasts and our own audio blasts and our own newscasts for our own individualized businesses that we can have either as the main income source for our life and resource or revenue in a business, or the sideline aspects of our life of being a trained journalist, is that we have the right to produce any work we like, both visual and visceral and audio cast, in a way that we might. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth from our own souls. But here's what I know about my opinion as a pagan. My opinion as a pagan is that I don't mind that I have an opinion as a pagan. And my opinion as a pagan is that you have no fucking clue, apologize for the language to those of you who are offended by that, but I'm trying to make a passionate point that most of you don't know what a pagan is. And most of you, if you come from Christendom, call people that you consider immoral or Satanist pagans. And we're not. We are people of faith that practice a different version of faith than you. Most of us pagans believe in a Lord because that is the tenets of the Pagan Federation. And whether or not we are Wiccan or Druid or some of the other marvelous terms, like a Merlin and whatnot that we tend to call ourselves, we have to tell you that we believe in the magic of the communities that we live in, and we also believe in the magic of the Lord. But what I can tell you as a pagan and as a journalist, that I regularly use my columnist capabilities to render my opinion about faith. But when I'm doing an actual story that I'm paid to do for a different type of news agency, it is my job as a journalist to keep my faith practices, for the most part, out of what I'm reviewing, evaluating, or assessing, or reporting upon.